black woman is accused of basically tagging. Where's the paint? The officers demanded. We saw you do it, they said. Here it is.
Look at my bag. You guys are just sitting here saying I'm,
can you move it around for us?
Do you see any paint?
I'll cover it up.
Do you see any paint? Do you see any paint?
We can't see.
You guys just said I was painting on a wall, and I haven't been painting on anything. I just said I'm leaving. I'm making a TikTok.
So when I asked you that,
and I said yes. You no, I didn't. That's you said I no.
No,
you didn't. No, there is a reason to get upset because you guys are saying I painted on that. There's no paint. I haven't been painting on anything.
Okay. Do you mind just moving stuff around your bag so we can see? Because it's
take the bag. Look at it. I don't have any paint. What do I have to lie for? I just said I haven't been painting on anything.
You're giving me permission to look?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you see any paint?
There you go.
You guys just said I was painting on the wall. Do you see any paint? You guys are f***ed up. No, you guys are f***ed up.
Okay.
Do you see any paint?
You cannot come back.
Do you see any paint? Did you see any paint? Did you see any paint? Did you see any paint? Because you just said I painted on the wall. Did you see any paint? Did you see any paint?
Ivani?
Did you see any paint?
Ivani?
Did you see any paint?
You want your
so there's no apology? There's no apology. I was, you guys.
For what?
The officer said, apologize for what? For lying. You literally said, we saw you do it. Where's the paint? Or you lied, you saw nothing. You likely targeted this young black female and made assumptions based on various social biases you may hold. But even if I give you the benefit of the doubt, even if I say, Mr. and Miss Police, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt here. Maybe you were just authentically wrong. You thought you saw something, but you didn't. You know, people make mistakes. Once you realized you made a mistake, you then threatened her with arrest for criminal trespass. You refused to apologize as any other person in humanity would when they have accused someone of a crime and you were wrong. You got to think about this. Somehow, it seems some people, not all, but many, when they put on their police uniform, they abandon their humanity. Think about this. Have you been wrong before? Of course. Have I been wrong before? Yes, I've been wrong about somebody before. And if I'm wrong about somebody and I say, listen, here's what I think you did, and I found out they didn't, I say, you know what, man, I'm sorry. My apology. I was wrong about that. All right? And officers are supposed to have this level of professional courtesy. They're not showing courtesy. They're being rude and now threatening with arrest, even though she has proven her case conclusively. There's more.
We're asking.
You guys just accused me of painting on the wall. You just, yes, you did. Yes, you did. And I have it on camera. You just accused me of painting on the wall. You just accused me of painting on the wall.
If you come back here for one
I don't give a. I don't give a. I don't give a. I don't give a badge number, all that. The accusing me of painting on a wall. Going on a TikTok, y'all ugly ass.
Yeah. They said if you come back over here, you're going to be arrested. All right. Let's put up a picture of everybody involved here. Okay. The TikToker goes by Kitty Coco. I like Kitty Coco's style. This was the Burien Police Department patrol. You can see this in the background. Burien is a suburban city of King County, Washington, south of Seattle, all right? The female officer is MC McCall. All right? The female, excuse me. And the male officer you see on picture there may be part of the Burien Police Department, while the female officer may be part of the sheriff's office. We're still trying to get a conclusion on this. Now let's talk about the possible charges, all right? Remember, they said, hey, we don't give a damn that we're wrong here. Let this happen again, you're going to jail, man. All right. Washington State classifies graffiti as malicious mischief. The crime can result in fines of $1,000 and at least 90 days in jail. If the graffiti damages a property value more than $250, it can become a felony case. That's according to Lewis and Laws, all right? Trespassing in the state is a charge, is charged as a misdemeanor or gross misdemeanor. The first is punishable by up to 90 days in jail and a $1,000 fine, and the second by up to 1 year in jail and a $5,000 fine. So they were threatening to do this to a woman that they were absolutely wrong about. Dan, thoughts here?
There's so many layers of how this story tells you what's wrong with the policing system. So the culture of policing there, where neither person there can either clean up the situation or just admit, okay, we're wrong here. Okay, we need to build some trust and say, we messed up. We shouldn't have done that. All right, we're messed up. Now we're going to be on this TikTok or whatever. But you don't make it worse by then saying, trying to assert the higher ground and saying, okay, remember, the day, end of the day, I'm still a cop. I can arrest you at any moment. Even if I'm wrong, I'm right. That's why people hate working with police. I'm so glad you dealt or like threw out those statistics there of what false charges that could have been put upon this woman that she could have had to spend thousands and thousands of dollars fighting in court having to deal with. This is how we say over policing in our communities has such drastic consequences. And even when it doesn't end up being violent in a situation like this, it's such a nuisance and can be a financial disaster if it actually went the other way if she wasn't recording. Because so many people wouldn't have trusted her if the camera wasn't rolling the whole time.
Very well said.